say we're going to try out this dental stone or ultra hard orthodontic plaster. And there's a load of instructions there on the label. So it says the colour is white, water powder ratio 28 millilitres to 100 grams, soaking time 30 seconds, mixing time 30 to 60 seconds, process time 3 to 4 minutes, setting time 8 to 12 minutes, hard set time 30 minutes, fully hard set time 2 hours. And there's something else here. I'm not quite sure what that is, so I won't read that out. Just some ultra technical information. Mixing guideline: use clean containers for mixing. Correct proportion of plaster and water should be used as specified to get best results. Mix thoroughly with a spatula to obtain a uniform mix. So I'm going to mix up this whole pack, which is 1,000 grams, 1 kilogram. So using the mixing ratio, we will mix 1,000 grams or 1 kilogram of the dental stone to 280 milliliters of water. So I've got my mixing jugs here. I'm just going to set this on the scales just to make sure we've got the correct amount of plaster. So I'll just cut the packet with a pair of scissors. I've never used this stone before, but I wanted to try it out on smaller items to see if it would be a good alternative to concrete or other materials, just for smaller items. All right, so I'm gonna pour this in. So here we are, bigger mixing bucket. So I'll pour the contents of this smaller bucket into this bigger one. Try not to make too much mess. Right, so we're nearly up to 1,000 grams there. I think the wrapper probably weighed 10 grams. Right, so I've got a selection of molds here, ranging from different sizes to different thicknesses. So the thinnest will be this small silicon mold, which is a small frame. The biggest is this latex mold housed in a Plaster of Paris mother mold, and this will be the thickest mold that we're going to use. And we have a variety of molds in between those two sizes. Probably in between is a little fossil mold here. There's a mixture of silicon molds and latex molds of different styles, and range from smooth to like ones with molds with, or molds which will generate casts with little bits and pieces sticking out. So I want to test it on all different styles and varieties of molds. Right, so anyway, I've got 280 milliliters of water here, so I will mix that into the dental powder. I want it a bit runnier than that. That's not going to really help. Right, so I filled all these molds, and I found a little polystyrene cup there, so we can use that as our tester and our sort of canary in a coal mine. experiment to see how it sets. So, actually it's gone off pretty hard. I'm not sure how these detailed molds are going to come out, but I don't feel very optimistic about those. Maybe the less detailed and simpler shapes, like the candle holder molds here, and I've got the fossil mold there, of course. They make them out quite good. I had to add a bit extra water than what it said on the guidelines, maybe twice the amount, to get that pouring consistency. So I don't know how that's going to affect the plaster, but it will at some level weaken the strength of the plaster. So we'll just have to do a suck it and see here and see how it turns out, see if it's suitable for molds of this size. And I've tried plaster of Paris, which is a little bit too brittle, fine for making models to mold, but maybe not for proper ornamental pieces. And I've also used the harder plasters. Carve, a DIY molds, uses I think he calls it Hydra Cowl, and I think we call it Crystal Cowl over here, or Crystal something, I can't remember now. Which goes pretty hard, and I was hoping with the experiment with this dental stone that the plaster would go even harder than that. So we'll find out once these casts have cured, and we'll do the hardness test. So here we are at the half an hour mark, and the plaster is very hot. Feels hotter than what Plaster of Paris, the heat that Plaster of Paris generates. I wouldn't say ready for demolding at this moment, although it is pretty hard to demold this experimental piece. Little edge there, and that's pretty brittle at the moment. So we'll go through some stages. I'll check it again in another half an hour. But I'll probably wait the full 2 hours before demolding all of these items. So here we are after just 1 hour. It's cooled off pretty much down to room temperature now. So I'd be happy to decast some of these molds. So we'll start off with this fossil here. So we'll see how that comes out. So there we are. I think that's turned out very nice indeed. There's a few minor bubbles there that can be filled in quite easily, but yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. We'll try some others. So here's a frog from a small latex mold. And that's come out pretty well as well, if I can get that on the camera. Grip it. Try this big pine cone, which I showed you how to make the mother mold on, or I showed how to make the mother mold for this on a video earlier in the year. So there we are, that's come out lovely. Just a few minor bubbles. So there we are, you can see definition in that. So there we are, that's the pine cone, like I said. It still feels warm. Feels very solid. So far so good. I probably will use this dental stone in the future for smaller items, just for ease of use. Right, I'm gonna try one of these smaller items. There's a little lizard in here, or should be a little lizard. I might be a bit premature in this, demolding this smaller one. Again, that one's come out really well. This is a very detailed piece as well, and the details come out great. There's
I can't see any air bubbles in that. Although when I put it on the big screen later, I might be able to see them, if there is any. So yeah, very happy with that. I'm not going to try and break that yet. I'll do the break test after the 2 hour period. So this is the thinnest item. I was going to wait for 2 hours to do this, but after decasting the or demolding the lizard, I'm going to give it a go. Actually, the air is cracked already, so it's probably not a very good idea casting that thin. So we'll say no to that one. So there we are, there's a fail on that one. And even when that's cast right up, I can't see that being able to withstand any kind of a vulnerability to breakage, if that makes any sense. So yeah, so I mean that's, I don't know, just over a millimeter thick. Probably too small. Stick to resin on that thickness or thinness. So I've got a candle holder here. It was when I sculpted a long time ago. Or last year, I think it was. So it came off nice. A few air bubbles, but overall, pretty good, I think. Probably the dental stone's ideal for objects this size. Now, this should be a small fairy door thing that I also sculpted last year, so I'll take the mother mould off. So here we are after just 1 hour, it's cooled off. Quite surprised, even though there are a few air bubbles in the plaster, the air bubbles are pretty minimal, and I didn't do too much of trying to tap the air bubbles out of these casts, because I probably mixed up too much for what I was doing, so I didn't have time to tap out the air bubbles with the rate at which the plaster was curing or going off. Right, so just got these silicone molds to demold. I'm going to wait another hour to demold these, so that'll be at the up to the 2 hour mark, and then we'll just summarize through the process. Right, so I demold these smaller casts from the silicone molds, but I don't hold much hope for these, because these molds contain casts which are quite detailed, but I thought I'd experiment anyway. Actually, this came out better than I thought. Not too bad at all. I probably won't use this type of plaster for these small detailed items in the future, but it was interesting to see how they did turn out. There's hardly any air bubbles in there either, and I didn't tap the mould. Sorry, on the screen there. So, pretty good. There's another. Not too bad again. And a definite fail there, the wings too brittle, and they obviously snapped off inside the mould, but the rest of the cast is pretty good. So there we are, job done. We've got a couple of failures there, just, you know, like the last figure we decasted where the wings broke off, so we won't cast any more of those. The little frame, of course, the plaster would be too brittle to make little frames like that. But the items, I mean, that's probably the smallest item that which was a success, which is the frog there. And even these Natsuki figure replicas came out pretty well, which I was surprised. I was expecting bubbles to be all over the place and it not to come out in one piece, but they did come out pretty well, although I won't use this particular dental stone to make casts like this in the future. But it was good to know how it works, get the feel of the stuff. All the other items, or most of the other items, were a success, like the candle holder here. I'd be happy to cast more of these in this dental stone. And the biggest one, which is the pine cone, which feels very solid, good detail. And these other ones, like the little fairy door here, and the fossil. These all came out great, but wanted something maybe that was quite easy to use and brings out the detail in the moulds to cast these smaller items. So I will definitely use this dental stone for the items like this and the more sort of solid, smaller items, but stay away from the more delicate objects. I mean, this stuff is about £6 a kilogram, so that is, I don't know, about $8 or $9 a kilogram. So you get a nice batch of casts out of the stuff. Anyway, I'm waffling on. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like and share if you enjoyed what you see, and subscribe to the channel. There's sort of loads of stuff on the channel, different types of things, arts and crafts, and all kinds of stuff. So anyway, thanks for watching, and over and out for now.